Hi, good morning. Today we are going to discuss one of the important social issues, the depletion of ozone layer. Before going to the depletion of ozone layer, we must know what is ozone. Ozone is a protective layer present in the stratosphere region of atmosphere. The atmosphere region is classified into 7 layer groups. The layer just above the Earth's surface is called troposphere. It's starting from the Earth's surface to 10 km of the atmosphere. After 10 km, the stratosphere region is there. The stratosphere region is 10 to 50 kilometers. After that, mesosphere and ionosphere. We come to the stratosphere region. In this stratosphere region, the protective layer ozone is present. The stratosphere region is between 10 to 50 kilometers of atmosphere. The ozone is made up of a O3 molecule through a photochemical reaction in the atmosphere. The ozone products a high energetic UV rays coming from the sunlight. If ozone layer is not present in the stratosphere region, all the UV rays directly fall on the Earth's surface. It causes severe damage to the biomass and material present in the Earth. But nowadays, due to anthropogenic activities, that is a man-made activities, severely damage and destruct the ozone layer. In this topic, we are seeing what are the sources for depleting the ozone layer and how it happened and what are the remedy measures should be taken to control the ozone depletion. The causes of depletion of ozone layer is mainly due to the liberation of man-made gases like chlorofluorocarbon, hydrofluorocarbons, halons, and hydrogen bromide emit from different sources like air conditioner and refrigerator system, even the manufacturing of packing material. We use freon and other gases. It contains halogens and also the cryogenic fuel. The burning of cryogenic fuel will emit a nitric oxide and other halogen material. It also capable of destructing the ozone layer. So all this ozone depleting gases are emit from a man-made activities. So this very fast rate, it will destruct the ozone layer. How it will destruct the ozone layer means the chlorofluorocarbons or hydrobromocarbons or hydrohalocarbons emit from various sources that contain halogens like chlorine, fluorine, etc. These are the two potential chemical substances capable of destructing the ozone layer. The chlorine in the chlorofluorocarbons or halocarbons decomposed in photochemically, it produces a chlorine radical. You know radical is nothing but a unpaired electron. It is very highly reactive species. So this chlorine radical go and destruct the ozone layer present in the atmosphere to produce hypochlorous acid. This hypochlorous acid is nothing but HOCl. It again decomposes to produce a chlorine. So, one chlorine is capable of destructing thousands and thousands of ozone molecule in the stratosphere region. So, through this chain reaction, it's continuously destruct thousands and thousands of ozone molecule in stratosphere region. A one chlorine radical is capable of destructing 1,000 ozone molecule in the rad, in the stratosphere region. So it leads to thinning of ozone layer in the stratosphere region. In some time, there is hole created in the ozone layer. So it creates a way to pass a UV rays from the sun directly. It fall on the earth surface, it fall on the living things, and it causes severe damages to the living things. So in this topic, we are going to talk how to control this ozone depletion. So what are the harmful effect causes due to this ozone depletion means? The excessive penetration of UV rays due to thinning or depleting of ozone layer in the stratosphere, when it fall on the plant, the chloroplast content present in the plant can be reduced. If it chloroplast content is reduced, means the photosynthesis process is also reduced, automatically the fruit production will be reduced. So the yield of the crop is reduced very much. So it causes severe economical damages and food crisis. And another thing, if the UV rays fall on the human beings or the animals, the skin cancer will be produced. It kills the skin cells, it causes a skin cancer. Apart from this, this UV rays fall on the materials like plastics, the polymeric linkage can be broken. So the polymeric material will be brittle and very soft. So the material damages and economical loss also occur. Apart from this, due to depletion of ozone layer, the climatic conditions of our globe can be increased. The climate change is occurred. So in Vienna Summit and Montreal Protocol, they can discuss about how to reduce the ozone depleting gases in the atmosphere. So this much of severe damages is caused due to depletion of ozone layer. So this is a time to reduce the ozone depleting gases from the man-made sources. So every individual and every person should have the responsibility to reduce the ozone depleting gases emitted from the various sources. So our international body, United Nations Organization, they conduct many seminars and many conferences and many international summits to discuss about the ozone layer. There are many submissions. First of all, the 1985, the Vienna Convention established the mechanism of international society how to reduce the ozone depletion gases and what are the harmful causes due to this ozone depleting gases. After that, the Vienna summit, many countries, approximately 24 countries, signed an amendment in Montreal Protocol. In that Montreal Protocol, the country will sign in the amendment, they do not use the ozone depleting gases for any refrigerator systems or any other activities. So these are some steps taken to control the emission of ozone depleting gases. Apart from this, we can use the alternative coolant or alternative gases for refrigeration, air conditioner system. So these are some of the measures taken to prevent the emission of ozone layer, emission of ozone depleting gases to the atmosphere. So another case study for the ozone depletion is the Antarctic North Pole region. There is a ozone hole can be created. Why the ozone hole is created on the polar region means, due to the low climatic condition, the temperature is very low in that polar region. So it form, it forms some clouds. That clouds is, the cloud contain high concentration of this halogens, especially the chlorofluorocarbons. So in that low temperature, that is around a minus 80 degree centigrade, due to formation of this polar clouds in this region, it depleting very fast rate in that polar region. So this is the reason in Antarctic and then polar regions, North Pole regions, there is a hole in the ozone layer. But one happy news, due to this COVID lockdown, the hole in this Antarctic region can be sink. So the hole cannot expand, the hole can be sinking. Okay, so with this I can stop the ozone depletion. Thank you.